Hello and welcome to InVision News. You are watching English Bulletin with me, Ratnakar. News in detail. A petty verbal duel over old enmity triggered fit of rage, resulting into a brutal murder under Ambassadori police station's jurisdiction late night on Sunday. Cops have rounded our father-son trio, Munna Mahato and his son Ramu and Chetan, in this connection. According to police sources, the accused trio picked up a quarrel with complainant Dinesh Naharkar at around 11 p.m. Following the intervening of the Naharkar family members, the chaos was sorted. However, the accused intruded into their house by breaking the main door and started manhandling Naharkar family members. It is when victim Ashok Naharkar came to intervene when the accused trio killed him with a sharp-edged weapon in front of his family members. Following the complaint of Dinesh Ambassadori, police have booked accused trio on the charge of murder and placed them under arrest. Further investigation is on. A special squad led by DCP Zone 2 Vinita Sahu on Sunday night busted a sex racket being operated at Hotel Dua Continental and Hotel Vedanta N under Sadal police station. Besides arresting one accused, Tulsi Das alias Saga Devi Prasad Hanumat, a resident of Ganeshpet, cops have also rescued two women originally hailing from Delhi and Mumbai who were forced into the flesh trade. One accused, Deepesh Kanbhar alias Gagan Thakur, is still at large. As per sources, the cops received a tip-off regarding a sex racket flourishing at the two monominent hotels under Sadar police station's jurisdiction. Acting swiftly on the input, the special squad led by DCP Zone 2 Vinita Sahu raided the two hotels and rounded up an accused and also rescued two women. The accused have been booked under the relevant section of the IPC while hunt of one accomplice is on. A 22-year-old Nepalese girl traveled all the way from Lucknow to file complaint against her rapist. According to cops, he had warned her of dire consequences if she tried to approach police. But the girl fled from Lucknow and somehow reached Nagpur and lodged an FIR against the man. The girl reached India from Nepal, was staying with a lady friend in Lucknow. After a few days, the friend introduced her with Praveen Rajpal Yadav, a Lucknow native. The girl complained about a monetary dispute with the lady to Yadav when they accommodated her at a resort in Lucknow. After a few days, Yadav met the girl at the resort and raped her. He threatened her to dire consequences if she tried to complain with the police. So she somehow escaped and reached Nagpur and lodged the complaint. The Nagpur Safe and Smart City project is being implemented through the initiative of Nagpur Smart and Sustainable Development Corporation Limited. Commissioner of Police Amitesh Kumar was among the officials who took stock of the development work under SAME at the Smart City Conference Hall in the Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj building of the Nagpur Municipal Corporation. The meeting was organized by the e-governance department of Nagpur Smart City project. Police officials Sunil Fullari, Dilip Jalke, and Reddy Vikram Sali, Vivek Masal, Rahul Makanikar, Gajanan Rajmane, Shweta Khedkar, and NNC official Ajay Mankar, Shakil Niyaji, and Smart City CEO Mahesh Morne were present on the occasion. Commissioner of Police Amitesh Kumar applauded the efforts of officials involved in Smart City's project to control crime through the network of 3600 CCTV cameras installed in Nagpur. He said that this has enabled many criminals to be caught. As many as 36 persons succumbed to COVID-19 on Monday. With this, the cumulative death toll in the district has reached 2,659. On the other hand, as many as 965 persons went home after recovery and obtaining permission from medical authorities. With this, the total number of recovered patients in the district is now 69,342, including patients who have recovered during home isolation and treatment. The recovery rate of the district is now at 84.35%. The total corona positive cases tally of Nagpur district is now at 82,207, with 746 positive cases coming to light in the last 24 hours. While giving a breakup of the deaths, medical officials revealed that of the total casualties, 464 and 1,934 victims are from the rural and urban areas of the district respectively, while as many as 261 persons are from outside Nagpur district. Well, that's all from this bulletin. For more updates in and around the city, stay tuned with InVision News. Till then, Ratnakar says goodbye. Please take very, very good care of yourself.